first thing to determine when you're looking at a spillway design is how big is the catchment. Best practice now though would be to have this, instead of it going out and coming around here, would be to basically do a contour out here, right? You can call it a swale if you like, and just have it go out another 10-15 meters that way, and then you can take, so you'll dig the swale or dig the embankment, and then once you've done that, then you'll scrape off the soil that you've discarded onto the bank as wide as you need the spillway to be, because it's difficult often to build them as wide as they should be in a valley, particularly when you've got steeper side. So we can put that out there. We could make that, you know, 15-20 meters wide if we wanted to. And then what will happen is the water, when it fills up, will go out on this level swale, and then when it builds up to the height of the old ground level, it'll run over. It'll build up behind the embankment, and then once it gets to half an inch thick, it'll run out on a level sill, right? And then it'll run out over this landscape, and then ultimately it'll come together from being quite a wide flow to concentrating, right? As opposed to it going through a narrow aperture, which is what we've got here, and then very quickly coming into a narrow stream, which of course, as the slope increases, it's only going to do some cutting. Now that's particularly a problem when the dam gets established. And think about it, you know, when's a dam at its most dangerous? It's when the landscape is not absorbing water properly, you know, it's all very punchy. This is not all grassed up with perennial grasses. You know, it's a kind of a dangerous time for the pond. Okay, so building these sorts of features in really takes care of that. And if it happens to happen in the summer, you get a summer storm, well then you get an irrigation of a bit of ridge. Well, I love putting these and sending them right out onto an adjacent ridge, because then the water immediately is going to spread right off the ridge like we showed today, right? So you can use it that, you can do it that way as well.
So a trickle pipe is where you put a pipe just below the level of the spillway. And so instead of the overflow immediately as its only choice going through an earthen spillway, it actually goes through a pipe. And that takes those sort of base flows, and it's not until you get a bigger event that the water will actually run out through the spillway itself.
Yeah.
And so it just keeps the water off the earth